While we're on the topic of human capital, how would an investor or any person really apply human capital to the decision of life insurance, how much insurance one needs?
Life insurance is a tricky topic. So we discussed earlier how one of the greatest assets that investors likely have is the present value of their future potential income from their work or trade. One of the risks to that, of course, would be for some reason if they were not here, if there were premature death. So a classic way of protecting people's families around this would be to have a sort of negatively correlated asset. And typically, life insurance is used in this context. It's kind of the inverse of human capital. So investors should think in terms of the mosaic of their total financial situation and think about the relationship that insurance may have with their human capital and the present value of this future stream of income. There has been a lot of research done around how to think of life insurance as an asset class. There are many abuses of insurance in the industry, but there are also positive uses of it. If you think of life insurance as an asset, often investors are searching for assets that they can own in their portfolios that are not perfectly positively correlated to other things they own. Examples might be stocks and bonds moving differently. Commodities, gold, real estate, and stocks moving differently. If you think about the relationship that life insurance or your life expectancy has with interest rates, the economy, and the rest of your portfolio, what you'd find is there's a very low correlation to the payoff of an insurance policy on your life as there is to the stock and bond market. So if investors approach insurance from an investment perspective, they might find that there's a place to fit life insurance into their overall portfolio and see what the payoffs, correlations, and relationships may be in the context of their overall strategy and situation.